Hi students, welcome to second year commerce class. Previously we have learnt about special provisions given by government of Telangana towards SC ST entrepreneurs. Now in this class today we are going to discuss about startups. Startups is a latest concept. You are very fortunate to have this modern and dynamic concept in your second year commerce itself. The students of previous generations and 20th century students do not know exactly how to start a company, and they did not have much encouragement from the government side to promote the entrepreneurial development. But today, as we are facing the challenge of unemployment problem, we do not have any other option except promoting the entrepreneurial development in the Indian society. So when enterprises are to be developed, always we cannot plan a company on a large scale basis with thousands of crores as capital or hundreds of crores as capital, because you know that Indian economy is a developing economy. It is very difficult to raise capital, because you know very well that capital can be raised only from surplus economy, where people have got enough earnings and they are saving their earnings in various modes like bank deposits or postal deposits. They are investing in stock market, they are buying debentures, means it becomes easy to procure capital. But in the context of Indian economy, it is very difficult. Around 60-70% of population of India do struggle to survive. Then there is no question of forget about providing capital to the joint stock system or to the industrial sector. Clear? So it is very difficult. So what to do then? How do you develop the industrial sector, or how do you encourage youth or say educated to start their own firms rather than searching a job in some other organization? See, when every educated individual look for job, means he wants to become employee, then who will become the employer? Okay, so if employers are there, then they can provide jobs to employees. But unfortunately in India, due to non-availability of capital, lack of technical education, brought up, many people do not venture into entrepreneurship. They feel that starting an enterprise is very risky, we require a lot of investment, and there is no guarantee of profits. So always they feel that rather than taking risk by venturing into business, let us go for a sophisticated job, either in the software or accounting side or in the finance side. So better being an employee is safer than becoming an employer. That is the concept of Indian youth. Means we do not have that challenging mind. We do not take risk. Always we want to play safe. Always we are worried about the investment. So in this process, what's happening is unemployment problem is increasing, as in the previous class also we have discussed it. So what we have to do then? We have to encourage starting up of various new companies, new enterprises, either in various forms. Maybe it has partnership firms or joint stock companies or private companies. We have to encourage the prospective youngsters, educated and other entrepreneurs to start their own firm. Okay, so startups are the, it is a new term given to a business organization which is newly established on small scale basis. Startup is nothing but a trial run basis, sample basis, where few individuals as a registered firm or as a private company, they start a enterprise, they start a business organization on small scale basis in the beginning. Then once it is successful, their idea has got scope for expansion and it is been received by the society, the product or the service produced by that startup has got demand in the market, slowly they can expand. So startup is a newly established company or which may be already existing but not done business on a large scale basis, okay, is called as a startup. I have given you the definition over here. A startup is a company that is in the first stage of its operations. What do you mean by first stage of its operations? Means now it has begun. Second stage, third stage means already goods are been produced, they have been reached the market and we have started earning profits. That will be the second, third stage. Beginning stage means now we are trying to develop our product. That is what called as first stage of operations. Means we have created the infrastructure, we have discovered the idea, okay, we have innovated something and we formed the people, we have got the common objectives, have come together. Now we have accumulated all the factors of production. Now we are ready to launch the production. That is what called as first stage of production. Means all the registration formalities are been completed. Now yes, you are able to produce a commodity or you are able to provide a service to the required customers. That is what called as first stage of operations. So a startup is a company that is in the first stage of its operations. Okay. Now various firms are there. So to be called as a startup, what it should have, what are its features? They are called as prerequisites of startups. Prerequisites of startup. If you have established a company or yours is a partnership firm, if you want to get benefits as startup or you to be called as a startup company, what are the features you should have? What are the requirements you should have? That is called as prerequisites. For example, in order to join intermediate, what is the prerequisite? You should have passed your 10th class. To join graduation, what is the prerequisite? You should have qualified in intermediate and having certain age. Similarly here, to be called as startup company, that company should have certain prerequisites, means certain qualities, some features. So some eligibility criteria is there. So what is the first prerequisite to be a startup? Matlab ek company ko startup company bolna bole to ye sab conditions satisfy hona. Only when these conditions are satisfied, then only that company is called as startup company. Otherwise it is a normal company. Okay, so what are the prerequisites? First one is company age. Company age means, see, it is not a normal person, no? 10 years old, 10 years, 15 years old, 20 years old. How do you decide the company's age? It is decided based on the incorporation date. For example, it was established in the year 2015. Now this is 2020. So the age of the company is 5 years. So the age of the company is decided from its date of incorporation. Okay, that because in first year you have learnt about joint stock company. How the company is created, how it has been incorporated. By submitting various documents to the register of companies, we register it. It is an artificial person. We have learnt that company is created by law. It is a artificial person. It is one of the feature. So we are natural persons. Companies and business organizations are artificial persons when they are created by law. So our life is counted from the date of birth. So what is the date of birth for the company? It is a date of incorporation or date of registration. So from the date of registration, we count its age. So company's age is counted from its date of registration or date of incorporation. So what is the limit? Period of existence and operations should not be exceeding 10 years from the date of incorporation. So if it is more than 10 years of existence, it is not called as a startup company. To be called as a startup company, period of existence means already it is there in the market. It was operating. It was producing some goods. It has already been registered. All the factors of productions are assembled. You have got the infrastructure. So that period of existence and operations, whatever the business activities you are carrying out, like producing goods or providing services, okay, are called as business operations. They were not exceeding 10 years of time period. From where? From the date of incorporation. Clear? So that means company's age should be less than 10 years, then only it is called as a startup. If it is, it was registered too long back, already started its operations around 15 years ago, 11 years ago, 12 years ago, then that business organization is not called as a startup company. Then company type means which type of companies are called as startup companies. Public companies are not called as startups. Remember this point. Public limited companies means where you issue shares and hundreds of crores of capital is already accumulated, procured from the people by issue of debentures and shares, then such type of company will not be a startup company. To be called as a startup company, its legal status must be, it should be incorporated as a private limited company. What is a private limited company? The minimum members are 2. I hope you remember. Maximum 50. So this is called as a private limited company. So the number of members are ranging between 2 and 50. Minimum number of members are 2. Maximum should not exceed 50. You know this. That is the number of members condition for a private limited company. And you know that at the end of every private company, you will have a suffix called private limited, X private limited, Y private limited, Reliance private limited, okay, some, anything, any name. When the end name of the firm ends with the words private limited, it is called as a private limited company. If it is a public limited company, we end the word with limited. Reliance India limited, Tata T limited, I hope all of you know this from your first year commerce knowledge. So the startup company always must be a private limited company or a registered partnership firm. Try to understand this one. Normally partnership firm may be registered or may not be registered. Normal partnership firm. But to be called as a startup, okay, it must be a registered partnership firm. Partnership normal, in a normal course, partnership firm can be carried out without registration also. It is optional. Registration is not compulsory for a partnership firm. But to be incorporated it as a startup company, to be called as a startup company, it must be a registered partnership firm. Then only you are called as a startup. Then annual turnover means the amount of sales you make. Okay, it is not profit. So many students will get confused over the turnover and profit. Profit is the difference of income and expenditure. Whereas turnover means the amount of sales you make per annum, okay, or per month. So here we are talking about annual turnover. Annual turnover means the amount of sales you make per annum. So should have annual turnover not exceeding 100 crores. So if you got 150, 200 crores of turnover, then yours is not called as a startup company. So your turnover must be 100 crores or less than that, but not more than that. Then original entity means
A startup company must be registered on its own. It should not be a company which is split from the other existing company. Like from a old company, if you reconstruct or reorganize or split up one company and then you call it a startup, means no. Startup is a original entity, means the promoters, the entrepreneurs who wish to start their business operations must have registered it, okay, for the first time, and they are carrying out the business activities on their own rather than dividing a already existing firm is not called a startup. Say for example, Tata Limited is there. So from Tata Limited, if you split one subgroup and now you decide it as startup, means no. Because Tata Limited company is a age old company, it has got vast experience in the field of industry. So it has got very great turnover. So from that, if you take small part away and now you say that it is startup, means it is not like that. It must be an original one. Then innovative and scalable, this is very much important. You cannot copy an existing product, or say you cannot just go for distribution. It must be innovative, either in the distribution model or production. You should have some innovation. That means develop a new product or a new model. Clear? Already we have discussed a lot about innovation. Then scalable. What do you mean by scalable? Changing the business operations capacity according to the requirement is called as scalable. Means expansion. So for example, we have got a junior college. Suppose if we get admissions into degree also, if we are able to convert this junior college into degree college, then it is called scalable. If we have got the flexibility of expanding your business organizations or increasing your size of business organization, then it is called as scalable. So I told you that startups are small firms, or the firms which are established with a motive of trial, okay, with limited amount of capital, with limited turnover. But slowly, once we are successful, if our idea is giving us good results, then we should be in a position to extend it, expand it, increase your production, then you can maximize your profits. So these are the prerequisites of a startup company. It is a new dynamic topic. So I wish you go through the textbook about this, and in newspapers also. When you see, government of Telangana has created a separate fund for these startups. Nowadays, so many startups are being encouraged by the government of Telangana, particularly in the IT sector. Various individuals, if you have got the habit of reading newspapers, you will understand that many youngsters who have done their graduation, BTech, normal BCom, BSc, okay, they have got some idea, and they are keeping their idea in front of the government. So government is encouraging them by providing capital, by sharing that idea with other existing companies. So these youngsters are provided technical and financial support by the government or by an existing company. So it is promoting entrepreneurial development. Many people, if you have got the newspaper data, you can understand it. I have seen two or three young graduates have last year in 2019, they have established a online dhobi shop. Nobody has imagined in Hyderabad. Normally we go for ironing, pressing of clothes, dhobi, in our nearby locality. Normal roadside shops will be there. But these guys, two or three young engineering graduates, rather than working in software firms, they thought that it is better to own their own firm. So they have started online dhobi. Okay. So what do? In Gachibowli area, they have established a workshop with a large scale 2-3 washing machines and around 15-20 workers. So they take orders. That means just simply they go to various apartments of software employees and they collect the clothes, wash and iron, then they deliver. So it is completely online system, sophisticated system. Only collection and distribution is offline, but everything, payment, taking orders and everything is online. So they are doing that very well. So many people have come like this. So that is what called as, even you see this Ola, Uber have come up only by an experiment by few individuals. Okay, already I might have told you this last year in classes. The Uber firm, which is providing you transport facility to book cabs, it was established by a young driver. Earlier when he used to get calls from different people, he thought that why shouldn't I establish a call center and I should link up with 10-15 drivers and can engage my cars so that I can provide transport service and I can get money. That's how all these Olas, Ubers have come into a force. Like that you got, so you can get so many ideas and you can implement it in a practical manner, for which you are getting lot of encouragement from government. So I wish you gain all knowledge and you also try, right?